Ladies and gentlemen, the George Pomutz Service with Dignity Leadership Award is presented to a Romanian public servant who has proven constant effort to impeccably fulfill work duties and go above and beyond, often at high personal risk. The recipients are men and women who undoubtedly serve as role models for the community. By their high professional and ethical standards, those nominated for this award are seen as guardians of the good society, leaders among their peers, and a source of pride and inspiration for us all. This award is offered in memory of George Pomutz, U.S. Army Brigadier General of Romanian descent who served in the U.S. Civil War. In 1866, he was named Consul General to St. Petersburg, where he participated in the negotiations for the Alaska Purchase. To present this award, it gives me great pleasure to invite to the stage Mr. Vasile Iuga, Senior Advisor, PricewaterhouseCoopers, and Board Member of Aspen Institute, Romania.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Before presenting the award, I would like to share with you a recent initiative coming from the Aspen Young Leaders, which is about the introduction in Romania of what would be called the National Service. It is our ambition as Board of Aspen to take this initiative with the broader Aspen community, the broader Aspen network, in order to transform it into something meaningful for our country. For those of you who are less familiar with the topic of national service, it may be worth mentioning that in the early 20th century, in a number of Western liberal democracies, was introduced the national service. And this was an opportunity and an invitation for the young generation to spend time with the society in helping to resolve important challenges in different areas: military service, conservation, education, health, but also an opportunity for them to build bonds and to become closer and to be closer together, in order to advance the civic features which were needed in a complicated political and international context. A few examples. In the United States, during the Great Depression, 3 million young people worked on a massive land conservation project. Also, for instance, during the Second World War, 12% of the American population fought in the war. And military education helped the American servicemen to bring some of the values back into the society. As a result, United States have experienced post-World War II what they called the greatest generation, which has seen involvement in a number of social, civic, economical issues. As a result, society was better off. In the 50s, this initiative went on decline in all the Western liberal democracies. Some of the results we are seeing today: civic apathy, people being more disconnected, an erosion of the values. In order to address this important challenge, a number of countries in the Western world have restarted their national service programs, among them the United States, Germany, and France. Romania is not different. We see the same symptoms in Romania. I'll give you a few examples. Only 12% of the Romanian people have ever took part in voluntary related projects, compared to 35%, which is still small and low in Western Europe. The dropout rate, school dropout rate in Romania, stays at 17.5%, almost 10% higher than in Western Europe. So Romania suffers from the same symptoms. And the idea would be to take this very generous initiative of Aspen Young Leaders and transform it into a framework, including a legal one, whereby young Romanians would be invited to give to the society or to invest in the society 1 year of their time in different projects. And we see here two pillars, one being the civilian one and the other one being linked to our military, to our servicemen. And the one which relates to the military pillar is about helping and supporting the social reinsertion of our young veterans. We see a number of Romanian servicemen delivering great work in the battlefields far away, and it is our duty to try to help them to reinsert in the society. And in this respect, we would like the previous winners of the George Pomutz Award to join us in this initiative in order to take it forward. I think I spoke already too much on this initiative. I would like to, with your permission, to move now to Romanian and share with you a few thoughts on the winner of George Pomutz Award tonight. You have on your tables in the booklets a more than complete version of the exceptional CV of our winner tonight. Cătălina, soția mea și cu mine, suntem onorați să înmânăm premiul George Pomutz pentru servicii cu demnitate unui ofițer superior din armata română cu realizări profesionale excepționale, confirmate într-un CV absolut impresionant. Este vorba de colonelul Cătălin Ticulescu, în prezent comandantul Unității de Integrare a Forțelor NATO în România. Domnia sa, muntean originar din Brezoi, Vâlcea, era un tânăr cursant la Școala Militară a Forțelor Terestre, pentru care schimbările din 1989 au reprezentat o oportunitate, pe care a valorificat-o din plin, prin muncă intensă și asiduă, cu respectarea unor valori puternice, cum ar fi patriotismul. În definiția domniei sale, patriotismul este respectul pentru țară, familie și prieteni, sentimentul datoriei și tăria de caracter. Prin parcurgerea unor etape de formare pe multiple planuri, Cătălin s-a dezvoltat ca un lider militar capabil să conducă misiuni complexe în echipe multinaționale contra unui inamic hotărât și viclean. Într-o perioadă în care se vorbește din ce în ce mai mult despre creșterea importanței tehnologiei în operațiunile militare, Cătălin ne reamintește prin prisma experienței sale personale din teatrele de operațiuni din Afganistan despre rolul fundamental al caracterului, al moralului în obținerea victoriei. El împreună cu un camarad au fost primii răniți din batalionul Rechinii Albi în martie 2006 în provincia Kandahar, în timpul unei operațiuni de patrulare. După recuperarea rapidă la Spitalul Militar Ramstein, li s-a recomandat să se întoarcă în țară. Au refuzat și au revenit pentru a fi alături de colegii lor. Dovadă de mare caracter. Nu pot să nu citez aici pe Norman Schwarzkopf, care spunea: leadership-ul este o combinație puternică între strategie și caracter. Dacă ești însă obligat să renunți la una dintre componente, păstrează caracterul. Tot în legătură cu operațiunile din Afganistan, el ne împărtășește experiența excepțională a camaraderiei, esprit de corp, cu militare din Statele Unite, cu care a participat în misiunile NATO, despre colaborarea cu aceștia și despre grija acordată și tratamentul impecabil de care a avut parte când a fost rănit. Și, în sfârșit, mi-a vorbit despre bucuria durerii. Cu calcaneu rupt și câteva oase zdrobite la laba piciorului, el s-a recuperat complet. Din când în când îi mai reapar dureri care nu-l supără, ci aduc aminte de faptul că este viu și că viața este frumoasă. Sub comanda sa, Unitatea de Integrare a Forțelor NATO din România a atins capabilitatea deplină în iulie 2016 și își îndeplinește rolul pentru care a fost creată, acela de a facilita, de a accelera, dacă va fi cazul, venirea trupelor aliate pe teritoriul României. În acest fel, parafrazându-l pe Winston Churchill, dormim liniștiți noaptea pentru că există bărbați adevărați gata să acționeze cu hotărâre împotriva celor care vor să ne facă rău. Îl invităm pe scenă pe colonelul Cătălin Ticulescu.
Before starting my speech, which I have prepared last night like a good military officer, to not come unprepared to a meeting, I just want to say something else. Now, I have noticed what one of the previous awardees has said, that he was looking in the room and he has seen that he was the only one dressed in blue, which is true. Now, I was also looking in the room and I've noticed something else. I've noticed that under the umbrella of Aspen Institute, here tonight, we have artists, sportsmen, politicians, military men, other services, businessmen, and I think this is something quite amazing, because Aspen has managed to bring together so many different specialties, occupations, however we want to name it. And actually, this is a reflection of the world we are living today, a comprehensive world, interconnected, like one of the previous speakers also said. And I think this is very important to understand that it cannot be one without the other. And while somebody is creating and inventing things, some other people are guarding, some others are selling the creations, some others are the beneficiary of the inventions, and that's a great world, and it's great Romania is part of European Union, like Mr. President has said, and it's great that Romania is part of NATO together with the USA, shoulder to shoulder, and I think all this is great, and we live historical times, and actually we are part of this new history. Now. Thank you very much. That was not on my speech. Now, as I said, as a good military officer, please allow me to read the speech I have wrote tonight. Distinguished guests, I am truly honored to receive this award alongside other notable leaders from across Europe. I humbly accept this award, acknowledging all the guidance and support I receive from people in and out of uniform who do their best to make a positive difference each and every day. Therefore, I dedicate this award to all my fellow Romanians who serve this country, whether at home or abroad, to help Romania achieve its full potential. And to the members of and to the board of Aspen Institute Romania, please allow me to pay my respect and admiration. By your efforts, future leaders learn something extremely important, which is, quoting Walter Isaacson, to do something greater than yourself, to serve the world, and to help others. Thank you very much.